When I process any photograph in Lightroom, there are three main things that I focus on: composition, tone, and color. Now, of course, there is more to processing than just those three basics, but that encompasses a lot of what I do in Lightroom, and it's the approach that I use for the majority of my photographs. So the first step I do is I adjust the composition. In this image, that's going to be cropping and straightening. I'll select the crop tool. You can also use the keyboard shortcut R. When I use the crop tool, I like to make sure that it's using the original aspect ratio, unless I want to intentionally change that to a different aspect ratio, such as an 8x10 or a 1x1 square. And I also lock that aspect ratio so that it's not going to change as I make my adjustments. I'll rotate the image to straighten it, and then I'll crop it down so she's a little bit more in that third line on the left. And then I'll press that return key. My image is now nicely composed, so I'll move on to the next step, tone. I want to adjust the tone first because having an appropriately bright or contrasty image is going to make it easier to see the colors, so that way when I'm making those changes, then they will be the correct changes. I'll use the basic panel for these main adjustments. And to start out in the tone section, I'm just gonna click on auto to see what Lightroom thinks it should do. I think this looks okay, but it is a little too bright. So in the exposure, I'm gonna click on those numbers on the right and just use the down arrow to move it down a few notches. I'm just gonna tab through to the other adjustments, and I'm gonna go all the way down to the whites. And I'm gonna reduce the whites. I'm gonna shift tab, which will bring me backwards in that list. And I'm gonna increase those shadows. You can also use those sliders to manually adjust those settings. So I'm going to decrease those blacks so they're a little less intense. At any time, you can preview the before and after by using that backslash key. Now, to finish, I'm going to adjust the color. And because this is a raw photo, that's going to be the white balance. The white balance in camera was pretty close, but it could be warmed up a little bit. And I might even increase that tint one or two notches. So now I have a nice base image to work with. So from here, I could continue down the list and use some of the other adjustments to amplify or stylize this photograph. But that three-step process is going to give me a really good start and a nice, clean photograph.